You got Ukraine fans are in the building, and friends from Kenya as well are in the building to make sure they can see what will happen in this very game. Good crowd, good atmosphere, and a good weather for a game of football here at the Mandela National Stadium. You're going to see most of those scenes for the rest of the evening, because the hosts have always commanded what we call the crowd. They're here in numbers, and they're hoping they finally can pick yet another 3 points and qualify for the next round. 3 points for the Uganda Cranes in this game will take them to the next round, and as well 3 points for Ethiopia will take them to the next round. So it is a battle of two sides that know what winning already is like at this year's tournament here in Kampala. Black Lions, they are called the Ethiopian national side, are up against the Cranes. Well, if nicknames are anything to go by, then maybe the Ugandan side have no chance. But it's the Black Lions up against the Cranes. Big game it is this very afternoon. Pedigree at stake as well. If results so far are anything to go by, all your viewers across the region, to remember you can listen to commentary between Uganda and Ethiopia in both English or Luganda as well. All you have to do is go to the language option on your remote, go for 1 out of 2 or 2 out of 2. Variety coming in from your World of Champions. Do cater for
ladies
all the
and
languages.
Gentlemen, the next match, Uganda and Ethiopia.
To most probably, the two teams are yet to make their
will
way out
kick
of the tunnel.
Shortly.
That big yellow
the match is graced by the presence
the
of the two ministers.
Practically, what
the
game is supposed to be about. So then there they come, the Uganda Cranes in their customary yellow shirts and black shorts on the left of the picture, and Ethiopia are on the right in yellow and green. 16 second part Tusker trophies between these two sides. The Uganda Cranes having the upper hand with 12 of those having last won in 2011. And of course Ethiopia themselves haven't tested any success in the regional tournament since 2005, but we'll be hoping to have a shot at this year's edition here in Kampala. It's a big moment for the big players, and this is the starting 11 for the Uganda Cranes today. Couple of changes. Hamza Mwonga comes in for the injured Abo Daira in goal, and up front as well a start for Emmanuel Okwi, as he will be hoping for goals with the Uganda Cranes. Henry Karunji, Godfrey Warusimbi, Dennis Guma, and of course Hassan Waswa will be looking to keep it tight at the back. Clinch, it's very important at this stage of the competition. And some trickery and probably interesting plays from
match,
Moses Oloya.
This
is one the fans will be looking out for. Ethiopia decides to start with Samson Asfo. Captain Fikru Kepera keeps his place in the starting 11. And Yusuf Salah is one of the new players that comes into the opening 11. Alongside Robel Grima Tega.
Liam
Kabede will be hoping to pick maximum points against the defending champions. And these are the players the coaches will be looking out for in case they need to change proceedings. Hamis Diego Kiza, best in Dar es Salaam with Yanga, does make it to the bench. It's not the last game, so he does drop the bench this time round. The Ethiopia, Abraham Abebe, one of the options they'll be looking out for to come into this game as well. Time for the anthems.
Thank you.
the Ethiopian anthem next is for the Uganda Cranes. The Cranes will only have one thing on their mind, just like the Ethiopians: pick maximum points and make it to the next round with a game to spare. When you do some of these tournaments, no one chooses your first 11 throughout the group stages. You want to qualify early and make it to the next round. That is what Bobby Williamson or Seyun Kabede will be hoping they can get from today's game. So then our referees for the day, Muhammad Arfadir from Sudan, will be helped out by Muhammad Itam from Sudan as well. Ambrose Hakizimana, all the way from Burundi, and Thierry Nkurunziza will be the fourth official. Speed time as well, a couple of pictures came down for the archives, Ethiopian team. Now this is their best chance to come back to regional supremacy. Can they take the championship from those men on your screen? Uganda Cranes, labeled by many as the team to beat at this year's tournament, and the fans know that. Both teams will be using the same formation in today's game. 4-4-2 it will be. Bob Williamson has got a way of having lots of mobility in his squad. You can expect their front man, Robert Sentongo Manko, maybe to come on later on in the game, but as of now, Brian Omon, Emmanuel Roki, and probably Joseph Ochaya will be having lots of movement up front. They will be looking out for Grima Bekere Debere. So give them some width every time they are attacking. There is the man from Scotland, Bobby Williamson. Done a good job with the Uganda Cranes, already won this championship, but failed to qualify for the Africa Cup of Nations. He says this is the tournament that should bring back faith for the fans. Maybe qualify for Africa's most prestigious and glamorous soccer showpiece. We're just seconds away from kickoff now. So referee Muhammad Arfadil takes his final knots and maybe final touches. Officially kicking us off the commentary box this evening. I'm joined by Mark Sally. Take us through commentary for the opening of 45 minutes. This is a game of two teams, Mark, that already know what winning is like at this year's tournament.
Yeah, absolutely. They've already tested victory. It was identical wins for them, 1-0 in their opening games. The winner today, of course, advances to the quarterfinals. And the loser is left to fight it out with Kenya for one of the two automatic spots there. Of course, there's a possibility that all three of those big teams will qualify at the Expos of South Sudan, and a few other teams in the other groups, of course. It's a possibility of being a lucky loser. Well, the best loser, actually. I don't think it should be lucky.
Oh, the best loser never sounds a better phrase anyway, but if that can get you into the next round, then we will work with that. So then the Uganda Cranes having the early exchanges here. Long ball looking for Emmanuel Okwe from Henry Kalunji. It's Ethiopian team. Have done lots of rebuilding as well. They have completely brought a very experimental side here. Only five players in this entire team are above 20 years of age. It again shows you how you have got to develop a team and make sure you can compete for bigger tournaments. Ali Constans for Uganda as the captain is on the ground now. Hassan Owaswa. Good news for the Uganda Cranes.
Yeah, he came through the back of him. Didn't look like bad challenge that. It's a little knock on the ankle, you thought. He looks like he's got a problem with his back as well, the captain. Currently playing without a club. Professional in Turkey the last four seasons. He's right now a free agent, using this tournament to showcase his talents again so he can be picked up perhaps one of the teams in the region. Some of his teammates already play in the Tanzanian league, and he could easily have been partners with another from Kenya, Daniel Seroko.
Oh, the captain Hassan Owaswa, having taken the armband after Godfrey Walusimbi turned it down. I'm wondering why everyone wants to leave their country, so how could Godfrey Walusimbi turn up the chance of not being a captain of Uganda?
The official line was that he didn't think he was ready to lead. The unofficial line is that he confessed to his friends that he was angry that he had not been consulted when the decision was first made to make him captain.
Aloya loses possession at the center of the park to Mena Del Dalcho. Kenda Cranes expected to dominate possession here. Got the crowd behind them. Once again, that question of how crucial are the fans, how crucial is the 12th man in the stadium, is going to keep coming up in a game like this one. Did lose it though back in 1995, even when they were hosting, with all the fans in the stadium to Zanzibar. But can they do it once again this time round? It's very, very open to debate.
Yeah, I remember in the early 80s, in this tournament, when I first fell in love with Sakafa, Uganda hosted quite a few and lost them. There was that famous, or infamous, depending on which side of the border you are, infamous shootout with Kenya, in which Mahmoud Abbas stopped about three of Uganda's spot kicks and all. So it took Uganda 12 years, all of 12 years, to win this tournament again, and it was on foreign soil.
It's a long one coming up front, looking for Brian Omoy. Does well, keeps control of the ball. He's got options in the box. One of those is Oloya! It looked an easy ball, but the goalkeeper had to fully stretch to keep this in play.
It's good running this from Brian Omoy. Cuts it back. Oloya doesn't make clean contact, but the goalkeeper sees it's on target. Been wrong-footed, the goalkeeper. So he needs to double back and make that diving save, or else it ends up in the bottom of the net there.
So Uganda's first close chance, the first corner of the game as well, flooded into the box. Five yellow shots in there, doesn't get any of those. There's the man who just missed the chance, Moses Oloya. Pushing his back to Dennis Guma. Flooded into the box, they were looking for options. Chances for the Uganda Cranes so far. Godfrey Kizito, the latest to miss, controlling the ball in the box. And then Skuma's got a battle. Ikru Tefera Remese, captain of this Ethiopian side, having a tussle with the Victoria University defender. Games like this are the games players as well used to impress their managers for bigger campaigns, and Godfrey Baba Kizito has done that already, Mark.
Yeah, absolutely. Uganda's got about 6-7 players out there who first made their name at Sikafa before forcing themselves into the national team proper to play the World Cup and Nations Cup qualifiers. Godfrey Alusimbi is one of those we talked about earlier, but Brian Omoy and Emmanuel Key used this tournament a couple of campaigns ago launch their international careers. Abedaira, the man you talked about, who's out of the tournament with a concussion, he suffered, the goalkeeper, in the opening game against Kenya, is another that announced himself on the international scene using this very tournament. So now, Oloya has done that as well. So Ochaya is the man who's been handed the opportunity today to do the same. He's the one playing on the left wing out of Asante Kotoko in Ghana. Today, you've got to play a 4-4-2 with Oloya on the right and Ochaya on the left.
So the Uganda Cranes up against Ethiopia. 6 minutes gone here at the Mandela National Stadium. That is the latest foul. The Brian Omoy. So for the many professionals who've just returned to Ugandan football, it's a bit clumsy, I should suggest.
Yeah, the surface is a bit slippery and the players have got to watch their challenges. because a seemingly innocuous one turns into a reckless one, and you could see yellow or red for just getting off your feet. So they need to be really, really careful, the players here, with how they go into this tackle.
So Bekele Debele, the man guilty. Now Samson has fouled. The goalkeeper has work to do here. Trying to play it wide, and the referee does suggest he wasn't ready. Henry Kalonji is one of the players standing over this one. So Dennis Guma, Moses Oloya, who will strike this one? There is Oloya, takes a shot straight to the goalkeeper! That is a good save from Samson Ashfar, but what a rocket it was from Moses Oloya.
Oloya has got hold of this. It's Ochai, actually. The ball is traveling. It's hit with venom off that left foot of Ochai. What a spectacular save from Samson Asau.
So Ochai once again showing why the Ghana Premier League side Asante Kotoko wanted his services. He's got a little left. Now Ethiopia trying to build right in the center. Girma Bekele Debere stretching this one to the wing, looking for Zinab Shawartil. Good pass to the start of this game. Once again, both sides showing their intentions, even though Uganda have had the better exchanges so far, Mark.
Yeah, absolutely. Uganda playing it the very traditional way today. Now 4-4-2 means that they've got two wide players. Only two central midfielders. That means that Chizito Baba and Hassan must have their work cut out. Ochai, who helped them in the opening game against Kenya in a 4-3-3, has been pushed out wide. But they're moving the ball really well and getting into the wide areas. Regardless of how many bright shots Ethiopia have in the center of the park, they can't seem to get all of the ball as it is now.
So the Uganda Cranes will be hoping for chances. Here is Oloya running into the box, trying to look for options. One of those is just on the wing. Here is Oman! And the first goal of the day has been scored by Brian Oman. Bobby Williamson. And the fans will go on with celebrations here at the National Stadium. He did announce his appearance at this very tournament. And now Brian Oman has given Uganda the lead that could very, very easily take them to the next round.
Yeah, this is a little nice ball from Oloya. Okwi cuts it back. Very unselfish, Okwi. How he saw Brian Oman, I wonder. But Oman puts that away with his left foot. Ethiopia cut right open. They had no clue what was going on. Easy as you like.
So we got a Cranes take the lead. And with just 10 minutes into this game here at the Mandela National Stadium, it's Uganda 1, Ethiopia 0. Here come Ethiopia now trying, turning into the box, and that could have ended anywhere. The whistle from the referee does suggest there is a free kick for Ethiopia just outside the box. What exactly happened there? But look at how that came up.
Yeah, this is Henry Kalonji. His challenge is late. He could easily have been in trouble if Walusi wasn't doubling back, because that would mean he's the last man, and the referee would have had to make the decision to send him off. But Walusi Mbe's presence all of a sudden means that Kalonji escapes. Actually, it looks like he didn't even go into the book for yellow.
So Ethiopia have a chance of getting back into this game. Yusuf Salah, one of the men standing over it. They now capitalize. Goalkeeper to beat this is flipped over the wall, and there is deflection just by the wall itself. Still chances for Ethiopia. It's floated into the air. Chances well headed out. Isaac is seen there. Ethiopia still in problems. We're pushing this forward. They just can't find that man they're looking for. At the moment, their coach does seem to be happy. Seyun Kabede Moses Tedese Kogale, the man who just couldn't find either a teammate or the target. It's a trim start for Uganda, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. They needed to get the crowd into it. They need to take pressure off themselves by taking the lead. Now they can knock it around and enjoy themselves.
Here they come again, now twisting and turning, looking out for the goal scorer, Brian Omoin. The Ethiopian defense standing strong on this very occasion. As Uganda get their second corner kick. Ayoloya taking shot. And the Prince standing and twisting, but Ethiopia does well. Straight to the midfield. Yusuf Asala didn't start the first game. Coming for this one. He does seem to be the most creative player for them so far. As Godfrey Kizito loses possession, but quickly the Uganda Prince get it back. Isaac Isinde. Good running, this coming in from the wing. Here is Ochaya. Does well to keep possession of the ball. Once again, strong defending from the Ethiopian side, like we've been saying before. We've been put under pressure in the opening 13 minutes here. Even though they have conceded already, it could have been worse for them. Now, with all this crowd behind your opponent and your goal down and your Ethiopia, where do you go from here?
It's not easy, they are very young players, there's not too much international exposure at this level. They only need to keep calm and play their game. I don't think too many people expected them to win this one before the start. So they assume they are underdog position, take the pressure off them, enjoy themselves, can cause a few problems there. And as it is now though, Uganda into the control. Ochaya and Oloya have switched wings. Momentarily, so it's right foot on the left foot on the right. The two players are the future of Ugandan football in many ways, in more ways than one.
Debele looking to launch a long one up front. He does, looking for his captain. Lemesa doesn't easily get to that one, and that is an obstruction from Isaac Isinde. That's cost him a free kick. Was on Yonatar Kabede. Uganda Cranes now have a free kick to deal with.
Yeah, it's a blocking foul that on the man who actually got the winner against South Sudan in their opener. It's a good finisher, Kabede, he showed that. Striker that needs to be watched, and Kaluji knows that.
Chances for Ethiopia running into the box is free, and that will be an offside. The flag was up. So then Ethiopia showing calls for their appearance as well. They are having a goal at the Uganda Cranes now.
And it's that man again, Yonatan Kabede. We just talked about him. Yonatan Kabede, Tekle Mariam, scorer of their only goal in that game against South Sudan. The hunger is shown in him not being patient enough to steer clear of the offside trap. They need to watch him, Kalunja is in there.
Guma, one of those players that are crawling into the Uganda Cranes senior team as well. Richard is one of the best defenders in his generation. A few pundits and analysts plus critics have suggested he's got discipline issues. They left AC Villa, of course, for Victoria University. A solid defender, we must suggest. Here is Baba Kizito, as he's popularly known here in Kampala. Cranes opening the tournament with that emphatic 1-0 win. I'm using the word emphatic just because that's how big that result was for the Ugandans. Every time Uganda meets Kenya, is what we call the battle of the titans in this region. Kenya redeeming themselves today with a 2-0 win. Kenya South Sudan themselves. As now Uganda tries to build. Here are chances coming in for them with Ochaya. Back to Iguma. Brings this into the box, he's got options, one of those. Osema Okui. Okay. that might have lost the opening two games, but they're not the punching bag of this tournament, are they?
Certainly not. They've managed to keep the score lines down when they've lost only the 1-0 to Ethiopia. We thought it was a disappointing performance. Seeing them resisting Kenya today and actually having the better of the game in the second half, despite being hit on the break by Clifton Raise, we can say quite confidently that South Sudan have acquitted themselves very well. That they've surprised us.
So 1-0, it is for the Uganda Cranes at the moment. Zoloya takes this back straight, Isaac Isinde. Captain Hassan Waswa seems to be fully back to fitness. Lemesa, the captain of this Ethiopian side, trying to get past Guma. The young man keeps his composure. Godfrey Walusim takes a long one up front, he's looking for Emma Okwi. It's taken by Oloya. She's on the ball. Being criticized by some of the football fans as being very flashy. Oloya. Bob Williamson thinks otherwise. Now here is Lemesa. He's got five yellow shirts around him. Swings back. This is the midfield, and they're looking for Kebede. Uganda Cranes defending in numbers. Well, simple tactic to approaching games like this. If you take on an Ethiopian team, it's very good. Every time they move forward, as the fans celebrate, you've got to defend in numbers.
Yeah, Uncle Manny leading the song, as he usually does, always in fine voice. The Ugandan Cranes fans, when Uncle Manny is conducting. Yeah, but it's quite impressive that Uganda
will be moving forward now. Here is Aloya. So Chayak, twisting and turning, he's got space to cross now. Runs in the box, he's doing a good job, he's got options in there, and one of those cannot easily get to the ball. Emmanuel Okwi could very, very easily have scored Uganda's second. Now here is Lemesa. Ethiopia on the attack now, he's got Tedesa in the middle of the pack. Does find one of the options in the box, chance to shoot. Many will consider that a very, very open chance for Ethiopia. The guilty party is Walde Bayene.
This is a very well executed counter attack. Lemesa setting up Bayene. Bayene should have found the target there, really. Made Hamza Mwongi work or punished him for coming off his line prematurely. He didn't do either. Ethiopia hitting very quickly on the break after Uganda brought men forward. It's a warning sign for the Cranes. They can't take this. For granted, can't be an easy game.
The Uganda Cranes have been warned on two or three occasions that they can keep the possession. Every time Ethiopia get it, it will be a counter-attack. Aloya. And this red flag now, waiting for Guma, does give it to him, putting the change between the two wing players. As Aloya now twists and turns into the box, can they find options? He's the defender. The Uganda Cranes still in control of this one. Now, Ethiopia will take it away. Kanom finds his captain, finds Tedese, and he's brought down. So 20 minutes gone. Bring that statistic out. There are lots of challenges in the center of the park, and it's an easily balanced game.
Yeah, suddenly you look at that foul from Guma, and remember that against Kenya in the first game, he was living on the edge. He's trying to establish himself as the right back. It's a position when the senior Uganda Cranes are there for the taking. Consider that Simeon Masaba, the man who's occupied it for the last decade, is on his last legs, really. So Guma's got the opportunity, he's got the talent, he's got to show a little more discipline if he's to take it as his own, the right back position.
Ethiopia trying to move forward. Here is the captain. That is a very adventurous shot. Bayene. That is Robel Kima Tsega. New players brought into the team. Did not start the opening game. They just think he's got lots to do to convince their coach. Salim Kabede of a starting slot in their final game of this group. The might not be fully professionals. Most of this Uganda Cranes team are semi-professionals playing in the region.
Yeah. Emmanuel Okii starting out there. He's the max, top max man at Simba, Tanzania. Diego Amis Kiza is on the bench. Top max man at Simba's arch rivals, Yanga. Got Henry Sinde in central defense, plays out of St. George in Ethiopia. So quite a few players here who ply their trade outside of Uganda's borders, but not so far away.
Well, Ethiopia as well got their share of professionals in the team. Natar Kabede, the only man who scored a goal at this year's tournament for them. This is the second division in Holland. They will be hoping he can bring that exposure and experience. Maybe help the Black Lions here. As this is pushed forward, Brandon Moon is clear the target. And the Cranes did a good job in keeping that ball. Like I said before, they've got to know the threat from the Lions when it comes to counter-attacks. Brandon Moon is brought down now for Uganda's latest free kick.
It's in Abusho, Till shouldn't be doing this. It's an aerial ball. It's one he can win in a clean contest. Instead, he gives Uganda the opportunity to swing the ball into his area and face his goal. Brandon Moon was at his back to goal and was not dangerous. It's one of those bad decisions that defenders make that completely arc fans and especially coaches.
Oroya gives it to Iguma, does put it just outside the box in a tricky move by the Uganda Cranes. This has got to be pushed back now. Everyone for this Ethiopian team was inside the box. That is how much they don't want to concede the second goal. Good running now coming in on other wings. Here is Ochaya. Can he bring this into the box? He's got options now. And Brian Omoy has missed a sitter. Work from Ochaya, and Brian Omoy just couldn't find the final touch.
There's the explosive pace of this man, Andrew Ochaya, and his ability to cut the ball back with that sweet left foot of his. Brian Omoy, he should be tucking that away. He doesn't make contact at all. Bobby Williamson is wondering what happened. He's already scored in this game, but we know he's no longer as prolific as he was 3 years ago. Brian Omoy, he needs to get back to his best and pretty fast.
The Cranes piling the pressure, but Ethiopia standing strong. Still early days in this game, 35 minutes gone. Black Lions will sit back and know they can get something from this game once again, as Hamza Mwonga takes a long one. At the center of the park, we haven't seen a red card at this year's tournament so far. I can comfortably say it's been a clean one so far. Now Ethiopia's chance to throw this forward. Finds Lemesa, quickly cleared by Godfrey Kizito. Mixed up now in the Ethiopian defense, does give this ball to Brian Omoy. He's running into the box. Does he have chance to shoot? He does cross this one straight into the box. And that could have ended anywhere from Yared Zinabu Shawatir. Gima Bekera Debere could have turned that to the back of his own net. It's always very, very risky to see a ball from this kind of area, Mark.
Yeah, absolutely. Brian Omoy shows some very good football. Looking for another opportunity.
Uganda's fourth corner of the game! Of the post still in danger, a post again! And the Uganda Cranes are fighting the post more. Oloya, twisting and turning. He's got options in the box. Can he find any? Uganda Cranes have the post between them and their second goal. That was what you call lacking football, wasn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. Ethiopia have really got away with this. Abete.
So still more pressure from the Uganda Cranes. Here is Ochaya. He loses position. This is when you feel the Uganda Cranes could very easily have scored the second.
Yeah, that diving header from Henry Kaluji looking for his first international goal. Comes off the crossbar. Omoni is looking for his second goal in this game. Comes off the crossbar as well. And then when Kaluji is setting up to shoot, his captain gets in the way there. Uganda making hard work of scoring a second goal there. Ethiopia.
Ethiopia now. Some fitness concerns. Moses Tedese Mogale. But still on the floor. Some of the injured players being first team players. It's then that will completely alter the tactics in games like these ones. These fans will continue with the celebrations as of now. They know they got a Cranes have the lead. The Popozella has clearly made its mark on the world of football. Look at the difference. It's still just celebrating, but they are not very excited with the situation. This kind of scenarios also give the coaches some time to pass on extra tactics. So Mkabede is doing exactly that. He won't be the head coach of the Africa Cup of Nations for this side, but he's doing a good job in nurturing the next generation.
Yeah, the scoreboard looks bright and colorful, doesn't it? Kabede, the coach who just asked me about Ethiopia, I'm still wondering, puzzled actually, as to why he's left out his namesake. Because Mesut Kidane Beyen actually is the one I'm wondering why he left out. Good player, first game.
Well, Fikru Lemesa is going to be one of the luckiest footballers. Ethiopia, yet another chance for them off a set piece now. Five grim shots in the box, can it find any of them this straight? Hamza Mwange. Ochaya, one of the players that are having a very good run at the moment, seeing lots of the ball. Here he is once again seeing it. Got good press running into the box, does well, can he keep this in now? Again, the Cranes are fully exploiting those wings. Ochaya and Oloya are running rings around this Ethiopian defense. It's when fans get disappointed, because with all the chances they have had, Mark, they should be leading more than this.
The Ethiopian goal has lived a charmed life. In the last possession, you gotta really should have scored. Brian Omoni, that rebound of a header, was from just about 1 yard out. Found the crossbar after Kaluji's diving header had hit the same woodwork. But yes, you are right, Ochaya and Oloya, two exciting wingers, perhaps arguably the most exciting players in the Ghana team at the moment. Exploiting the spaces, they find out wide. It's gonna be difficult for Kyoke to stop those two. Really young, really energetic, and Ochaya actually has made history. First Ugandan player to fly his way to West Africa. Playing in the Ghanaian League with perhaps the oldest team on the continent, Asante Kotoko.
Asante Kotoko, always involved in one of the biggest derbies on the African continent. You see Emmanuel Okwi's yellow card. Every time Asante Kotoko plays against the Hearts of Oak, the entire West Africa is on a standstill. But now here is Godfrey Warosibi looking for Uganda's second in the game. Cushion will be very important. Looking for Oloya, can he keep this in? Yes, he does. He's got quick feet as well. But this time round, loses out possession very easily. Mena Medercho. Ethiopia will have come into this game knowing the Uganda Cranes haven't lost a competitive game since 2004. Times wonder how crucial those statistics are. Do they affect the mental strength of players, Mark?
Well, it's a tough challenge. It's a tough challenge for any opposition team. Even when Zambia came here, the African champions, you had all that bravado about ending the run and everything. It plays on their psyche. It plays on every opposition team's psyche. The fact that the team has been a formidable home record. It's always in the subconscious. The back of the mind implanted there. And then it's also a confidence booster for the home team, Uganda. Feel it's like it's a given that they should win, like it's their divine right that they should win every time they step out of the Nampole pitch.
So will that record hold on until the end of the tournament, or will someone break it? Is part of the debates here in Kampala. They might have that record as well, but they have been heartbroken on two occasions. Yeah, it's Nambole by both the Harambee Stars of Kenya, the African champions, the Chipolopolo. They might not have lost in both games, but they did not qualify for the Africa Cup of Nations on both occasions. Now here come Ethiopia. Looking for space up front, good running from Bekere Debere. Yusuf Salah. Finally settling in this game, starting to put a few passes together. We've got so they still have time. We have time break, maybe to pull one in this very game. Or for the delight of most fans in this stadium, they're gonna try to take a bigger lead. Long one looking for Moses Oloya. He's got Dennis Guma in support. Can you find him? Yes, he does give it to Guma, and it's not the best of passes. And that man's reaction does suggest so as well. And the Cranes using most of the wings, but they don't have the biggest strikers at the tournament. So maybe it's one of those tactics Bob Williamson is playing around with.
Yeah, one of the things that Okwi and that Oloya and Ochoa should do is cut the ball back low when they get in there. But what you have to understand is that Brian Omon has got the leap of a basketball player. Small, but he can get up there. We've seen him on that rebound from 1 yard out. You saw he outjumped all the Ethiopians and was up there. He's got the leap of a basketball player. And you can't be scared about crossing the ball high if he's in there.
Dennis Guma battles for possession, does lose out. This is quickly brought into the box. Here is Fikru, captain of this side, doing a good job in holding play up front. Tedese stretches this one wide, and not the best of passes. Gotta be fast for Yusuf Salah. Yusuf Salah will be hoping to impress Siyoma Kabede. Probably start the next game as well. Ethiopia being a historical African nation, just one of the first three countries to play in an African Cup of Nations back in 1957, alongside Egypt and Sudan. They have also gone on to win this World Championship on four different occasions. 1987, 2001, 2004, the latest in 2005. Of course, the only team out of the entire 12 lineup of this year's edition to play in the 2013 Africa Cup of Nations, but of course will be held in South Africa. I wonder if that gives them some pedigree coming into a tournament like this, playing a team that will be in South Africa next year.
Well, Ethiopia, what you've got to understand, they've got a rich football tradition. These might be youngsters, but they come from a nation that has got so much going for it and stuff as far as football is concerned. Good youth system, this is why they've got youngsters here. Great history, they played at the first ever Africa Cup of Nations finals. Then they won the tournament, they've been African champions before, which Uganda can't say. And also, finally, they are back there after more than a 30-year absence. They are back at the Africa Cup of Nations finals. 2013, they will be in South Africa. And this very tournament they are playing in, they're the third most successful team after Uganda and Kenya because they've won it four times. So they are a footballing nation in every sense of the word.
Well, the Ghana Cranes will say the last time they made it to the Africa Cup of Nations, as we see a chance here, this is the goal that the Ghana Cranes are currently standing on. That is Brian Omoni. Good work coming through from those wings, though. That man's face does say it all. I think he says well played. Scottish accent, not the easiest of accents to catch up with, but I think I picked it right.
You did. You're a good lip reader, Andrew. I can attest to that. That's exactly what he said, Cody. Well played.
Well, this is the second time the captain is on the ground, and now maybe the concerns about his fitness will come up. Hassan Owaswa. He's already left the pitch and he will be leaving it again. Mark, we're talking about Uganda's pedigree at the continental level. And if Ethiopia is talking about having won it and been there 10 times, maybe the Uganda Cranes fans will shout back and say the last time we were there we made the final, as of course back in 1978.
Yeah, one of four appearances Uganda has played in the Africa Cup of Nations finals. Unfortunately for the Cranes, that was their last. So it's been 34 years and counting. The last two occasions have been in Hartford.
Oh,
the failure to score against Harambee Stars here in the previous campaign, and then missing out after a dramatic shootout against Zambia only a few months ago.
Well, to put it more into perspective, if the child was born the last time Uganda was at the Nations Cup, he probably is now married. 34 years is such a long wait.
If he was a Ugandan footballer, he would most likely be retired. Born in 78 and retired in 2012, and Uganda still waiting.
Ethiopia now looking for that all-important equalizer in the first half with their captain, Fikru Lemesa. There's three Ugandans and that's what keeps possession. Very important to keep the ball, especially if you're goal down. Ethiopia having a very good spell of playing the last few minutes, and that is shown on the possession, 75% for the Black Lions. The Ghana Cranes still marginally in the lead on 55. So Ethiopia growing into this game. Look for his strike partner, okay. Recover from Yared Zinabu Shawatir. Ethiopia now will take their time. They've thrown that ball forward. Nothing has come out of it, and maybe it's a change of tactics now. They're building slowly and very gently. That is the latest. Fartir to the midfield, looking for Kanon. 5 minutes to half time. So if you've been following this tournament, you'll know 5 minutes are everything. Uganda Cranes probably have taken that foot off the accelerator now. They are sitting back. I'm hoping it's going to the half time break. Still leading, because now Ethiopia are fully taking control of the ball now, even though it is in their own half.
Yeah, suddenly they've got that football culture of a passing team, Ethiopia, the national team, but all their clubs as well. They like to knock it short, keep possession, barely dominated in possession stakes by any team, even those that beat them up. Sudan will bear testimony team that were the victims as Ethiopia qualified for 2013. Two very exciting legs. But this, like you said, is a very young team.
So Ethiopia will know it was always hard getting results against Kenya and Uganda. A good job in picking points off South Sudan. That man, Saum Kebede, knows he has 3 or 4 minutes. But then he can give them the other pep talk. He's gonna take this shot. They probably need to have their own shell position now they have realized. Pushed forward. This is Emmanuel Okwi on the ball. Does well. Brano Moyne does push it once again to find Joseph Ochaya. Yellow shots were waiting for that in the box, but quickly and well blocked. Back to Chaya. Good job, some trickery being shown by this Ugandan side. Every time as well. Show off part of your skills. You're going into half time, you're leading, and you're fully in control with the fans behind you. Show off some skill. That is what Uganda is doing.
Yeah, absolutely, but a 1-0 scoreline is not exactly comfortable, easy. Ethiopia can hit back at any one moment, they're still in it.
It's the foul on the Emmanuel Okwi by Pawon. You get a cringe just before half time, now half chance of doubling their lead. But can they? We've just seen the thunderbolt from Joseph Ochaya. He is not suddenly out of options. One of the men standing over this one. But okay, he's the man who could give Uganda the options. Here he steps forward, right footed, and that will be very, very easy for Samson. As for Woku. Half time, and there will be 2 minutes of added time as well. Four quick mark, that is. Now, this is pushed forward looking for Kabede. Isaac is in there, starting his ground. Lots of movement by this Ethiopian side. The usefulness in the side does help as well. Here is the captain, Hassan Waswa. Didi Dali is on the ball and loses out possession right in the center of the park, but does well to fight for it back. Strong on the ball, Hassan Waswa. And now here is Oloya running into the box. He's got the best. Does he have options? Yes, he can. And one of those was Brano Moyne. But solid defending from Yarin Zinab Shortil.
Yeah, Shodatil does really well to keep Brano Moyne out. Then when the ball comes back to Oloya, he slams it into the side netting and he's disappointed. That should be played into play by Oloya. Bobby Williamson not amused at all.
As we encroach halftime, Mark, I've got to leave you alone now and go do a presentation at the pitch side. Hope you don't get so lonely and maybe get out of control.
I'll be alone but not lonely. 22 players on the pitch down there, all those vuvuzelas sounding and everything. I'm in good company, thank you very much. I'll take it on from there and see you after halftime, Andrew. There's a foul for you. Brano Moyne knocked out cold. Seems worse for wear. Kele Debele taking him out. Assistant referee himself almost slipped up on that slippery surface. But Brano Moyne is back on his feet. The goal scorer for the Uganda Cranes. Solitary goal. Give Uganda this slim lead as we enter time added on. here, not with that kind of fast touch. Here's Aloya again. Muscled off the ball. Ethiopians just cannot find any teammates playing out of defense. Honestly, Ochai looking for Chizito Papa, but they've lost out now here. Ethiopia can cause them some problems. Chizito Papa makes amends for his terrible error. Now he's seen they will play it out to Guma. Guma looking for the run of Okwi here. Ends up in a corner kick. Bob Williams would applaud that. It's a great ball from Iguma there. Okwi seemed to be up and away for a moment. But then the defensive intervention from Zinabu Shewatia. Being very busy, the Ethiopian central defender. But here's a corner, perhaps the last kick of this half. If the referee will let it, because we've done the 2 minutes of time added on. Here it comes, in swinger. The last action of the half, I suppose. Well, not quite. The free kick, one infringement there. So the goalkeeper Samson Asau will restart. And there's the final, the whistle for halftime. It's a CAFA Tusker challenge game between Uganda and Ethiopia. Has reached the halfway stage. Emmanuel Okwi, the man who set up the goal, and this is the man who took that chance. Brandon Monye, tucking it away with his left foot. Chizito Baba, Ochaya, Henry Kalonji, and all the Ugandan players will converge on the pitch at halftime. Seems to be a ritual for just about every team at this tournament. The Ethiopians will not oblige, they're walking off. They're going to have the dressing room and try to come up with a strategy to do it here. It's been a good first half here under the floodlights of Nambole, but at halftime, it is the Uganda Cranes 1, Ethiopia 0.
The full moon is out here in Kampala as 45 minutes of action between Uganda and Ethiopia come to an end. And that is what football is all about in this tournament. It is the battle for bragging rights. It is the battle for supremacy. And as it stands, the Uganda Cranes will be the more excited of the two sides here at the Mandela National Stadium. Lots of sound being made by the Vuvuzelas from the Uganda Cranes fans on this side of the stadium. They are very happy because the defending champions, the 12-time champions, are leading against a side that has lots of pedigree in African football as well. Trust me, the scoreline is very deceptive because both sides have missed their share of chances. And I'm joined by Alan Asekamate. It could have been worse for Ethiopia, or actually Ethiopia could have equalized.
Yeah, it's been an end-to-end affair. Ethiopia acquitting themselves very well after a very difficult opening 10 minutes in which the Cranes were all over them. Cranes very quickly out of the blocks. Their performance today, especially in the opening 15 minutes, confirming that if anybody is going to win this CECAFA tournament, they must beat the 12 times champions.
Before we talk about the first half tactics and everything, look at the pitch. We have had two games on this pitch. We had some rain just before a kickoff of both games. Could this pitch be affecting play?
Most certainly not for the Uganda Cranes and the Ethiopia Antelopes. I think they've been acquitting themselves very well. They are not being affected by the rain or anything. I think their passing is very good. Their movement is very good. And I think we are watching some of the best football in the 36th edition of this tournament.
Those fans are chanting Brian Omoin because he's the man who has given the Uganda Cranes the lead. And in case you've missed any action from the opening 45, let's quickly take you through some of those highlights as the Uganda Cranes once again did stamp their authority on the tournament. The Uganda Cranes first on the attack.
Yeah, absolutely. Very quickly out of the blocks. Both squared. Moses Oloya should have been doing better. Very good work down the left-hand side from Omoni. Oloya must have launched a pile driver there.
All right, there you go, Uganda having the first of chances. And that did not seem the easiest of chances, but the goalkeeper struggling to keep it on. But once again, it was the Uganda Cranes moving forward.
Once again, Moses Oloya at the center of things to Okwi. Okwi squares it. Brian Omoni, no mistake, is the joint top scorer in Ugandan football right now. Remember, in 2008, he was also the top scorer of this tournament right here in Kampala. And he shows what he's made of.
So Brian Omoin doing a very good account of himself and starting in today's game. Great strike. Here is Emmanuel Okwi making that run from the line. And boom, it was for the Uganda Cranes to take the lead in this very game. Bobby Williamson, of course, his expression at the moment does suggest he is a very happy tactician. Ethiopia as well had their share of chances.
Yeah, Ethiopia, of course, trying to bounce back into the game. That is Mesfin, the man who plays in Vietnam. The ball is skied over the bar. Otherwise, their movement has been very good, Ethiopia. Their passing has been excellent as well.
They might have struggled at the beginning in terms of getting chances, but this is a good chance. Most strikers would say, at least I should have found the target.
Yeah, absolutely. That's the man who created the chance that created the winning goal. Then Uganda, two headers across the bar. That should have been behind the back of the nets. At this particular stage of the game, the Uganda Cranes were piling the pressure.
This is why they say luck and football can comfortably be mentioned in the same sentence. Two balls off the crossbar. The Uganda Cranes could very, very easily have taken a comfortable and probably further lead at that point. And Bob Williamson shows. But here is Oloya again.
Absolutely. Oloya has been a constant thorn in the flesh of the Ethiopian Walia Antelopes. Bobby Williamson, of course, sporting that moustache in promotion of a fight against prostate cancer.
Very interesting. Let's quickly now look at the first half in numbers and I'll fully go down to possession, 55 to 45. But look at that. Shots on target, three, and the Uganda Cranes have just one goal.
Yeah, three shots on target. I think the goalkeeper has done well enough. He's tried to keep out the Uganda Cranes. Then, of course, shots off target. Uganda Cranes double the number of Ethiopians. Possession 55%. So Uganda have had the better of the opening 45 minutes. Apart from a five-minute spell between the 35th minute and the 40th minute, where the Walia Antelopes were dominating possession.
Well, like I was saying in commentary as well, it hasn't been a dirty tournament. Just one yellow card from the opening 45 minutes. We haven't seen a red card yet. But the big question now is, we are approaching the second half. What options are on the bench for both coaches trying to make sure they can change the game?
Well, Uganda Cranes have been dominated in the middle a bit. I thought that the two central midfielders, Hassan Wasswa and Geoffrey Barber, were a bit isolated. I think the coach will be asking Ochaya and Oloya to play closer to the center to try to dominate. Of course, Uganda Cranes have Hamis Diego Kiza, the younger striker, who did very well at CECAFA last year. He can't come off the bench. For Ethiopia, they do have players like Chara Deriba. Chara Deriba coming off the bench in the opening game of the season. And then, of course, Mesfin Kidane running the South Sudan left back ragged, a very useful shot number 7.
Well, a couple of those Uganda Cranes players have not seen any piece of action now, including Brian Magweja and Nicholas Wadada. Robert Ssejongo has seen some action, but maybe Saidi Cheyune will be coming on, and Arias Mamo for Ethiopia. Abdurakim Hussein, who did start the first game, have been dropped to the bench. Maybe a few chances that should be coming in for them. Just before I ask you anything else, I didn't have a chance to ask you for your prediction. Does it end this way?
No, I think there are plenty of goals. Both the teams are attacking. They are very exuberant in their play, very expansive in their play. Ethiopia should be able to get a goal. Uganda Cranes should be able to add on to the one they have.
There you go. Alan thinks the Uganda Cranes are going to score even more goals in the second half. But he also says Ethiopia will come back into this game. Both sides did win their opening matches here in Kampala. But also do remember, we've got more action for you at this year's tournament. Action will be coming in as tomorrow's action is breathlizing as well, all the way from a pool a B, and one of those is Somalia up against Sudan. Somalia having conceded the most goals so far, they conceded 5, and it was against Burundi, who will be taking on the Kilimanjaro Stars in tomorrow's game. 1600 EAT and of course 1800 EAT as when both games will be live and exclusive here on your World of Champions. Now at CECAFA, we're also promoting hygiene. We are asking you to go out there and wash your hands every activity you do to make sure you're clean and you keep healthy, and then you can watch matches here on your World of Champions. In case you don't get what I'm talking about, here it is ahead of the second half.
For great football, it takes two things: fit players and fit fans. Play your part. Always wash your hands with soap before eating and after using the toilet. Wash United and CECAFA working together to protect the beautiful game. Wash-united.org.
Welcome back to the Mandela National Stadium here in Kampala. It's the second half of this CECAFA Tusker Challenge Cup game between the hosts Uganda and Ethiopia. We are under the floodlights. We have already had 45 minutes. The full moon, the beauty of Africa once again showcased. The sun during the day, the full moon during the night. Not too many parts of the world can claim that. Uganda, being every bit equatorial, is one of the most beautiful. Look at the fans. Enjoyed their first half there. First half in which Uganda scored just the one goal from Brian Omonyi. They threatened to run away with it. They didn't. As a result, Ethiopia are still in it, just the one goal. They can hit back. They showed signs of recovery. Now they'll be hoping they can complete that recovery. Our referee Mohamed Al-Fadil from the Sudan getting set to start this second half. Uganda unbeaten at home in a long, long time. Looking to maintain that record. Looking to add on to the 12 region leading CECAFA titles that they have by confirming their place in the quarterfinals. If they win today and have a maximum 6 points from two games, they will be in the quarterfinals even before they kick a ball against South Sudan. So we await the start of the second half. That is because Ethiopia will make a change straight away. Yonatan Kebede, Teklemariam, goal scorer of their winner against South Sudan, has been taken off here and replaced by Abraham Abebe Kasaye. So here we go. Prince starting the second half by attacking straight away. Right to left on your screen, they're putting on the yellow and black strip. Ethiopia have the green. He has a chance already for Kwi. Didn't steady himself in time enough to pull the trigger. Uganda have already won themselves a corner kick inside the first minute of this second half.
So the Uganda Cranes making their intentions very clear in the first few minutes of the second half. They need the second. This is swung into the box. Can they find options? One of those is Karunji. Karunji, the tallest, the tallest player for this Crane side, and he just couldn't keep his ball on target. Then confirmation of that substitution, Jonathan Bede, the man who did make way. I'm wondering what the coaches were telling these players at halftime. Probably Bob Williamson is saying go out and attack or actually defend the lead.
Yeah, go out and attack, go for the jugular, score a few more goals, make this game safe. Ethiopia are saying we're still in it. Just the one goal, one or two signs that they could get back in there. A little more conviction. And they can actually go level. So everything to play for in the second half.
All the statistics between these two sides to suggest the Uganda Cranes have won 8 and of course drawn 8 against Ethiopia. Ethiopia themselves have 8 wins. Uganda Cranes scoring 32 goals. Those 24 matches, we want to concede 28. So those statistics are anything to go by. The Uganda Cranes will be conceding. And maybe, just maybe, Ethiopia will come back into this game and take the lead. So the Cranes take this shot, looking for chances. Second goal is very, very crucial. They need that cushion. Kalonji takes a long one up front. He's looking for Godfrey Kizito. The Cranes take it back. Now it is Ethiopia's chance of moving forward. Kebede looking for options, can't find any of those because Godfrey Warusimbi is quickly off his line.
pushes this one forward, and defending coming in from Yaride Zinabu. Of course, got language options for you. You can listen to commentary in this very game in Luganda as well. Rost Riamuhora, our Tabira Endeba winner. Let's go to your remote. Press the language button, pick either option 1 out of 2 or 2 out of 2. We'll be able to have the game in Luganda commentary. As this is plotted in, the flag is up, but will not count.
Yeah, he's marginally offside. We've seen that Kaluji have pulled out of Walusimbi. He's gone into attack. Lucky not to go into the referee's book, the substitute Abra Mabebe. It's illegal for you to kick the ball away after the whistle. The referee being lenient on that occasion. Mabebe gets away with it. Foul there.
From Lucy, the biggest of players.
Cranes, but probably one of the hardest men to take down. So when he goes down, it suddenly was a foul. Good battle between Fanon and Hassan Waswa, two big men, as now Ethiopia tried to break away with Lemesa Fikro. Here is the captain. He's got two men to beat. Has lost possession quickly to Hassan Waswa, the captain. He finds Godfrey now. Baba Kizito. Here is Igoma, Dennis. Taking it forward, looking for Emmanuel Opi. And once again, lose possession. It's a battle for territory in this very game. Uganda Cranes currently camping in the Ethiopian half. Long one. It will be a bit too high and too fast. Williamson is a face of a very impatient man at the moment. Probably looking for that second goal. That's what it means against sides like Ethiopia. Up front to see that ball. No ball is their captain Fikru Emesa. So Lucindy takes a long one. They got a Prince looking for an attack, but the referee thinks otherwise. And they get it back now. They got a Prince. Emmanuel Okwi. Pass misplaced, just looking for the goal scorer. It's Breno Moin. Come once again, the Cranes looking for all those spaces they can get in that part of the pitch. Here is now Awolusimbi Godfrey bring this into the box. He's taken control of Moges Tedesa Bogale. So the Cranes mark at the moment simply lacking options and creativity every time they get into the final third.
Yeah, Ethiopia doing a good job of setting up stall. That the delivery from Walusimbi in the last possession typifying the fact that Uganda have not quite elevated themselves to the same standards of the first 15 minutes of this game. But they know they need that second goal. They won their first one 1-0, but they cannot take it for granted that they can do it a second time. It can be anything. It can be great team play. It can be a moment of individual brilliance. It can be a terrible mistake, the howler from the goalkeeper or defender. It can be a freak goal, sucker punch, anything can get Ethiopia back into it, as long as the scoreline stays this way. So, still plenty of work to do.
Isinge.
regarded as one of the best penalty takers in this team, Isaac Isinde. Be shocked if he took the penalty. He never got the chance to get in a game like this one. Getting a little bit slower, so it's probably very cautious. That is the offside, very, very questionable. Simply onside, but of course, the third official has the final say as well. Yusuf Osala. So 1-0. For Uganda as we approach the hour mark here at the Mandela National Stadium. Can Ethiopia pull one back? What they've got to defend first here is Baba. Twisting and turning in the midfield. Well, structured by the referee. Seen those happen on a couple of occasions. And now Fikro running into the box. He's got an option on the left side. Does take a tumble. What easily could have been their best break so far in the second half ends into a tumble. Maybe now the turf is having its own say, and the rain we had earlier, man.
Yeah, you hope that he wasn't going down looking for the free kick and that he just slipped up on the turf there, because it was a promising move that collapsed so miserably there for Ethiopia. But the danger is there.
They'll be looking for chances. Zamonga had quickly come off his line. Fikru Lemesa, most prolific striker for them. That did fall to Yusuf Salah. And as always, been said to be a very, very small margin. Bleaching it takes microseconds. The Ethiopia, plus the Ghanaian players will know that. The battle in the midfield does continue.
All of a sudden Uganda have adopted the high line tactic, which Kile has got to have been discussed. There's the offside. Yes, he is offside, three of them actually. Only the one in whose direction the ball goes can be punished according to the rules, the new rules on the offside. The thing though is that I'm surprised Uganda, I've not seen Uganda deploy a high line and offside tactics before. A bit of respect for Ethiopia they're showing here.
Good movement coming on this left flank. That was good movement from Joseph Ochaya. But he does a tumble on the ball as well. He took his eye off the ball for a second. Makisi C, a footballer in the Bell Ugandan Super League. A good policy if he takes control of this one now. As the game wears on, you keep wondering where Walusimbi gets all his energy from. It's just when you think some of the players are getting tired, it seems faster. Okay, Ochaya, he's got an option in the box. Can he find any of those? Good defending coming in. From Girma, Bekera, Debele.
Debele does well, but the pass from Okwi is not the best of them. Ochaya is out wide. If he plays it a little more wide, Ochaya can use his pace and those long legs and that left foot to get beyond Bekele, but terrible pass.
The feed as well, just when he thought he would blow his whistle early. And I can't feel his lips this time. He's trying to do that, but this time I've failed, Mark.
I'll help you.
What is he saying?
He doesn't agree that that ball went out. He says, hey, the ball didn't go out. I speak Scottish, you know.
I think I like
my third language.
I like your Scottish accent this time.
My third language, yeah.
I think you should commentate for the rest of the game. Yeah.
After Lugana and English, Scottish is my third language. Comes in before Swahili.
Oh, there you go. Talk about being versatile. What Mark has just showed me here. as Ethiopia does more defending now. Coaches around the world make a couple of substitutions in the hour mark, wondering whether Williamson will run for one of those. As it stands, nothing has changed. So far, especially for the Uganda Cranes, including Dennis Iguma, traditionally a central defender, plays the same position for his club, Victoria University. Once again, that is a good quality of a footballer, isn't it?
Yeah, he's known for his versatility. Sometimes they say it works against you if you can play different roles, and you don't know which one of those is your best, but I think Iguma is naturally a central defender. We've seen him play in central midfield for Uganda at different age levels, under 23, under 20. Now he's playing at right back. Iguma fancies himself as somebody who can play virtually anywhere. But this is his breakthrough tournament, really. This is when he can actually stake a claim on that role. Like I told you, the man who's not here, Simeone Masaba, has played at about five different Sakafas, played for Uganda as the right back, the mainstay right back, for over a decade. But he's on his last legs.
So Chaya trying to find space between two Ethiopian defenders. They do well. Talking about the Cranes players that have been perennial campaigners in this squad. The Moisigwa is certainly one of those. The senior national side captain doesn't make it this time as well. As Bob Williamson says, he wants to look more at both Isinde and of course Henry Kalunji. Probably doing a good job in trying to make sure he gets new players in the national fold. Ethiopia, right in the middle. Vionatal. Panom takes this long. Now here's a good chance for them to float this into the box. They've got the captain in there. Lemesa does well. Tries to set up Nabu, but just couldn't find him. But here come Ethiopia once again. This is a good spell of pressure from them, looking for their captain. Must be offside. Yes, he's offside. There's a man running through and very easily could have left that
he part. Should never have got involved, the captain. That's why he's saying he didn't hear his teammate call out to him to leave the ball. He was already offside, the captain, as you can see here. But the man they're playing the ball through to, Abebe, the substitute, is actually onside. If he lets Abebe get involved there, Abebe is in on goal and troubling Hamza Mwange. Terrible decision from the captain.
So Ethiopia having their offside numbers go up. Probably showing the level of need for an equalizer in this game.
Yeah, it's a bit of their ambition, Andrew. But also the fact that Uganda, since the second half started, have actually adopted that high line that surprised me. Pulling out at every Ethiopia possession, all across the back four, from Iguma and right through Isinde and Kalunji, down to Alusimbi on the left.
So Ethiopia probably now replying with long-range shots. The latest not being successful, thrown into the box. The captain is one of the options in there! That was a good chance from Fikru Lemesa. He's gone forward, he's looked for chances, and now he very easily could have put the Black Lions level.
This is a great delivery, and this is a great diving header. That is a spectacular save from Hamza Mwange. Fantastic save from Hamza Mwange, but the switch that brought the captain forward has got to be applauded. The change of tactic, the change of positioning that brought the captain forward from defense to attack could just about pay dividends for this Ethiopian side. That's the second time in about as many minutes that they're threatening Uganda's goal.
So Uganda have to be more attentive now, because Fikru Lemesa has shown them just what he can do. On the other side, Hamza Mwange is
probably telling Bobby Williamson, I need to be the first choice. That was a brilliant save from Uganda's second choice goalkeeper. Very clearly, Ethiopia have been the team on top of proceedings, 72% of that possession in the lead. But can they find a goal, Mark? They've got to keep pushing throughout the game.
They need to. Uganda has shown some vulnerability at the back. A few times Ethiopia have attacked in the second half. They've come really close. The closest, of course, being that header from Lemesa. They keep probing and knocking on that door, it just might open.
Oh, will the door open? Let's wait and see. Now the Uganda Cranes still pretty much having the bragging rights in this game. 64 minutes gone here at the National Stadium in Nambole. Mogas. Ogale. Trying to have a quick counter attack for the Uganda Cranes, but misplacing that one. He's looking for Emma Okwi. The Cranes have been well supported at this year's tournament. This could have very easily been a mistake from Ethiopia. Hassan Wasa does well, leads this one on. He does just play on nothing. Now here is Godfrey Warosimbi, the man who easily could have been the captain of this side, but quickly finding his footing and maybe getting that ball. As Panom. Like I said once again, the Uganda Cranes, every time they get to this area, they seem to be learning lots of new things. They're running out of options.
They've gone into a mini slumber. Trust me. You can't take the credit away from Ethiopia. They're the ones who stepped it up in the second half, playing much better. Uganda have got to shake themselves awake. This man has got to do something about it. Scream at the players on the pitch to wake up and stop taking things for granted, or even make a change. Got a few good options on the bench there. I don't think Okwi, for example, is having the best of games today. Brian Omonya has gone quiet since he scored. Ochaya, team drop for the second half. Very active in the first. He's on the ball.
So Ochaya brings this into the box. Not so many options he's got. He's got this Brian Omon. It's easily dealt with by this Ethiopian backline. How can they break away as Hanson Waswa commits a foul right at the center of the park? Beyene, one of the new players in this Ethiopian side, actually taking the free kicks. Probably one of the most agile players in this Ethiopian side. Seen a couple of late goals of this year's tournament. But both sides will be hoping to be the ones on the score sheet. 23 minutes to go. Like we said before, that is a long time in football. Long ball looking for Fikru Lemesa. Easily taken away by Henry Kalunji, who now takes a long one up front. Looking for Emma Okwi. Scored Ochaya in support. Emma Okwi does well, keeps possession, running in the box, but quickly loses that one. Now this is brought into the box by Ochaya. The Cranes having good spells, like we said before, they now seem to be crossing it more and more. One of the days when the Cranes had the likes of Hakim Magumba in the center of the back, lots of creativity between players. Now Bob Williamson is actually relying on wingers back.
Yeah, especially today because he's got two central midfielders that operate from deep. Chizito Baba and Hassan Waswa. Waswa sits right in front of the back four, barely crosses the center line. Then when Uganda is in possession, Baba is a little more mobile than that. Actually, he came forward and scored in the first game, but he too, naturally, he is a deep-lying player. So it's the wingers that have got to take this team forward. The only good thing about his 4-4-2, otherwise it would be a flat one because I don't like that formation myself, is that Emaokui is actually mobile. He comes off from on, drops deep and picks up possession. Only minus today is that he's not having his best game. By his very high standards, Okui is not having his best game at all.
Uganda ranked 86th, the latest FIFA rankings. Again, it's an Ethiopian side. It's number 102. This Uganda have seen better rankings before, being ranked 63rd. 95. Ethiopia started off with better possession in the second half. Now Uganda seem to be growing into their character once again, putting a few passes together. That is evident. 48-52, so their possession rate is reducing. Chances for the Uganda Cranes shot. Easily straight to Samson Absolwaku. Williamson's movement on that touchline clearly shows he is not very comfortable with the 9 attempts that Uganda have scored, considering they've scored just once. The lawyer is brought down. Has a chance of maybe now moving forward. Vietnam, big country, have the services of many Ugandans. See whether he can execute this to the right. Uganda has 5 yellow shots in the box. Can this ball find any of those? Comes in low. And have another chance to cross now this into the box, twisting and turning. Back to Loya. Ikuma. Man who was trying to bring that post back but didn't easily get back to it. Yeah, he is now. Can he float this forward? Yes, he does. Can he find options? Yes, he can. Good movement this by the Uganda Cranes. Second goal, very important. Uchaya. He's got the skill. He's brought down and the referee does suggest that will be a free kick.
Is a foul, even if Moges Tadese Bogale will want us to believe otherwise. Machaya is coming alive. The Cranes have actually woken up from that mini slumber.
So 72 minutes gone. The latest free kick for Cranes. Oloya brings this into the box. Headed out by Yared Zinabu Showatir. This is taken shot running in the boxes. Okwi goes back to Oloya. There was an offside. The third official does suggest. And Ethiopia will take it as fast as they can. Ethiopia making yet another change. Chelsea, Raheem Walde. Ochala, Deliba. He's come on and have his part to play in the opening win against South Sudan. One of the attacking options that the Black Lions have got. Uganda Cranes trying to keep possession. Iguma. Oloya. Elonji takes a long one. Looking for Iguma. Nice attack right from the beginning. There's a chance for coming in for Omoni. Didn't seem to have enough space to play his shot. But nevertheless, it met Samson Afsosogu. Help someone.
Yeah, it's taken 28 minutes for Moy to get involved in the game since the second half started. And then he almost got his second goal for his troubles there. Good control, good hustle. Couldn't put power behind that left foot shot. Went straight at Samson Afsosogu, the goalkeeper for Ethiopia. But Brian Moy had been quiet since the start of the second half.
Good running this by MLP. Now here's Oloya, he's got space to shoot. Not the best of shots. Bob Williams unexpected from the Vietnam best Oloya. Was that almost went in for a throw-in? Disappointing for a striker with that quality, as now Ethiopia make yet another change. Abraham Abebe Kasaye. The latest man to come on. Now this is Elias Mamo. Attacking options. Ethiopia making their intentions very clear here.
There is a surprise for me, Andrew. Abraham Abebe Kasaye was only a substitute. Came on for Jonathan Kebede, Tekle Mariam, man who scored against South Sudan. He's been taken off. Been 29 minutes on the pitch to be exact. And it looks like it's a tactical change because, well, he was running straight to me. Didn't seem to have a knock at all.
Well, tactics are changing second by second. Yeah, the Mandela National Stadium. All the players will play 90 minutes and some won't even make that team. Now Ethiopia looking for that all-important equalizer. 4 points from this game give them a very big chance. Make it the last next round. But as it stands, the Uganda Cranes will qualify for the knockout stages. Battle between Kenya and Ethiopia. This is the player who we're talking about at halftime, John Majega. The interesting, very pick on the ball, lots of trickery he's got. Winger and Bob Williamson as well making his intention very, very clear. Mr. Kuchaya has lots of defensive qualities in him. Less than Majega, so he's coming in, tracking out, attack is it
Yeah, absolutely. Kuchaya actually sometimes plays as a left back. Did so, did for KCC, and has done so for Asante Kotoko. So Kuchaya can play, plow that entire wing. Majega is literally a left winger. One lefty for another, but one without that many defensive qualities. Majega is just going to have to push Uganda forward. Kuchaya, like I said, had come off the boil a little bit from his high octane performance of the first half. Wasn't really involved in the second.
Well, here he is. And he does announce his appearance with the free kick. Majega, one of the players involved. What you'd call a battle between clubs here in Uganda. The KCC were fighting for his signature a few months ago. And that made it to KCC. How skilled he is. Well, he's standing over the ball for this one. Quickly brought into the box. Can they get a friend to find options? Iguma brings this one back in. He is looking. Oloya. Ethiopia throwing everyone behind the ball, but quickly turning defense into attack. It will be an offside. So points on keeping the two top strikers up front. If you look at that offside.
Yeah, again, that high line is pretty deliberate, if you like. Close to the center line, Uganda really pulling up there, catching Ethiopia offside.
5 times Ethiopia have been offside. Now we've got some issue. Brian Omon and Emmanuel Okwi keep the leading strike force for Uganda. Maybe so many fans expected James Deokiza to be the first man off the bench.
Yeah, you'd have thought so, but Ochaya himself had run out of steam. Look at this foul. It's Okwi straight into the back of Bekele Debele. Yeah, you'd have thought either one of Okwi or Omon would have given away by now. There's two other lethal strikers on the pitch, perhaps not great users of the ball at their feet, but Robert Sentong and Diego Amis Kiza can put the ball in the back of the net. They've proved that in this region.
Yeah, it seems all right. Final 10 minutes here at the Mandela National Stadium. And they're gonna Cranes hold on. Or Ethiopia take their 4th point, even their 6th point of the campaign. They won their 12th championship as well. Because Ethiopia done a good job to win it 4 times. So then this is the substitution we've been talking about. Manchester in Dar es Salaam, Tanzania, with the younger James Diego Kiza. He's come on for the goal scorer, Brian Omon. He's part in this game to give Uganda Cranes a shot at all 3 points. Look at his own contribution. Here he is, his first touch on the ball is an accurate one, looking for Emma Okwi. Looking for Moses Oloya now. He gets to think James Diego Kiza will be the target for most of the attacks Uganda will be having. Pressure of the strikers. He's also been brought on to work that back line. This is exactly what he's doing. And of course, Brian Madrega, one of the other fresher players in this squad. Here he is on the ball now. Can he bring across? James Diego Kiza is in the box and this is straight to the goalkeeper. It's him. Just peel it. And Samson Afsawoko got it back.
Yes, it was bubbling right there. He didn't get the bend on it and he wanted to find Kiza at the back post. Remember, of course, Madueka is making his Sekafa debut.
There he is now. Seeing lots of the ball since coming off the bench. He's got the best. Trying to keep this in play. The referee does suggest he actually pushed Tedese Bogale. Appearances at the Africa Cup of Nations for Ethiopia does suggest how strong they are from this region when it comes to continental tournaments. Uganda Cranes have struggled at continental level but have dominated the region. What are they getting wrong, Mark?
Well, in the past there have been issues with preparation, the teams. Then there have been administrative issues of all sorts of kinds. There's been politics interfering with the game. And then on a few occasions as well, believe it or not, some people don't believe in it, we've actually been unlucky. It's a combination of, it's a cocktail of reasons really, behind the failure to qualify. desperately unlucky against Zambia. Shootout that went on forever against the African champions, the last one. And how they did not score against Harambe Stars last year is something that still baffles me. Spent the entire game and the final third of Kenya and didn't score once. They only needed to score once. Incredible.
Oh, talking about luck, the Uganda Cranes have been unlucky on two occasions in this game. Two headers coming off the crossbar.
You know, there's a counter-argument to that. There are people who say the crossbar is of a much smaller circumference than the goal mouth. So if you find the crossbar not anywhere between the goal posts, you're not unlucky, but inaccurate. There are people who subscribe to that school of thought.
Some people also say if you hit the crossbar twice, then you won't score or you won't win again.
That is not even luck or anything. That is superstition. That's downright superstition.
Well, Bob Williamson will not want to learn about those kind of superstitions because he's hoping his side can pick maximum points. The Uganda Cranes will be making the next round as the shot comes in. Very adventurous right from over 40 yards. The Cranes now looking to surprise Ethiopia.
It's a good one on the turn. It is Okwi. This is vintage Okwi. He does this all the time. And the goalkeeper must be relieved that it's wide of his uprights and not inside it.
Okwi still looking to get on that score sheet. So the man who did score for the Uganda Cranes in Ndola, of course, against the African champions Zambia, a goal that gave them lots and lots of hope of coming here and qualifying. If you look at this foul on Moses Oloya,
yeah, Oloya taken out. Looks like so much fast for air. It didn't look like a very heavy challenge. Perhaps fatigue there. Uganda 15 fouls to Ethiopia's 18. I can barely recall any. None of them has been worthy of serious mention.
Well, the referee has also done a good job in keeping those cards in his pockets. Yeah, like I've emphasized throughout the presentation at the touchline, is don't have a red card yet. After 4 days of the tournament, is that a question of refs being very lenient or players being very cautious?
It's been largely clean this tournament. It's played in the right spirit. I said that yesterday, I continue to say it. And players are to express themselves. So many young players brought into this tournament. Some of the more experienced, some of the bigger names, stars in this region are not here. And the youngsters are out here to prove a point, not by kicking each other, but by outwitting each other.
Yeah. Only more time to freshen up things here. Now O'Brien Magwejwa is ready on for the Uganda Cranes, and Bob Williamson is now looking at Robert Ssentongo, top scorer in the Bell Ugandan Super League last season. Well, he scored 16, but he was awarded 13. On for the Tanzanian best once again, Emmanuel Okwi. He favored ahead of Ssentongo when the tournament started. And the Cranes having the latest attack here. But it will be a goal kick. Then Bob Williamson spoiled for choice. Look at the kind of strikers he has at this tournament. All the way from Brian Omon to Okwi. And they're looking at the likes of James Diego Kiza. And I've not even talked about the goal scorer, Brian Omon.
Yeah, absolutely. Four strikers, different qualities. New partnership now.
Running into the box, here's Brian Majega. Bring this. Just can't find James Diego Kiza. Is the man he was looking for. Run Majega having a very good time on that left flank, but this is the run mark.
Yeah, and you can tell the idea. He's going low. He's looking to find Amis Kiza in the 6-yard area. Ethiopia double back, and that man Bekele Debele has been the outstanding defender of this game.
Well, can he defend Uganda's latest assault and goal? Corner kick as we close into the final 90 minutes. This is flipped on. That means Diego Kiza. As at the end of that one,
flicked on at the near post. Hamis Kiza looks like he was surprised by the ball. Came off his head rather than him head it. But he couldn't put any direction in there. Trails over the bar.
Madrega. This game is getting more and more interesting as we close in. The big question now is, are we going to see a surprise goal here? A moment of brilliance is needed. Ethiopia. Lemesa. To Panon. Hamis Diokiza does well. The crowd appreciates his effort. And Panon does well as well. Keeps possession of this one. Before he's seen it. It's clear. Sound over the vuvuzela is getting louder here at the Mandela National Stadium. The fans, probably for the Ghana Cranes, are starting to sense 3 points. And not just 3 points, also the next round. How much Bob Williamson will tinker with his team if Uganda makes it to the next round now? You probably will not see any of these faces, one or two, in the next game against South Sudan. Know this player has a couple of minutes to do that. As Hamis Diokiza is brought down now for Uganda's latest free kick. And Mark, this is the time I leave you once again. And catch up with both coaches after the final whistle at the touchline.
Yeah. Can go down now. Gonna start the free kick quickly. There's a shot. Wide of the mark. Probably Williamson wondering why Chizito Baba went for ball from all of 30 yards out when they could still pass it around. Chizito Baba is a man full of confidence. Confidence born of great performances in the World Cup and Africa Cup of Nations qualifiers, and also the winning goal in Uganda's opening game at this tournament. The score of that winner against Kenya. As you see, yet another speculative one. Time from Robert Sentongo. So Uganda seeing this game out into the second minute of the three added on. We're hoping to hang on to this 1-0 win. Threatened to run away with it at the beginning. Found Ethiopia hard to break down since. That away. Loya has switched plans. He's come down here to the left. Now here's Kiza into the box. Cuts inside. Kiza is looking for Chizito Baba. But again, that man Bekele Debele in the way. He's intercepted just about everything. But the Cranes have got into the Ethiopian box in the second half. Madreka, left foot on the right. Baba. Being forced backwards by Ethiopians closing in. There's the captain, Hassan Waswa, barely involved in this second half. Now Oloya, right foot on the left. Walu Simbi. The cross, the goalkeeper is away. Oh, that's a good save from the goalkeeper. The shot again, and it's wide. Great interchange of play here between Walu Simbi and Oloya. The cross to the back post missed the goalkeeper. I miss Kiza's head. I can't find the target. And he cannot score off the rebound either. Robert Sentongo, the man
pouncing on the second ball and trying to put it away. This is a good save by the goalkeeper. He's kissing the ball between himself and the ball post. Saint Tonga is falling and putting it wide for the Williamson. Flabbergasted. But there is the final whistle now. They couldn't score a second goal, but they didn't need it at the end, because Uganda have got their second win of the CECAFA Challenge Cup here. This is the hero of the day. Rwanda Moyne is scoring the winner in the first half. At the time, it didn't look like it would be the winner, only the first of many. But as it turned out, Uganda have not scored a second, only hanging on to the first, because Ethiopia grew better and better as the second half wore on. And Uganda will celebrate. They could remain unbeaten on this ground. This is the goal that won it all, of which cut back, passed on to by Brian Omondi, slammed into the back of the net. Uganda enjoying maximum points here, and they lead. They're into the quarterfinals here, because of the final whistle, it is Uganda 1, Ethiopia 0.
It's done and dusted here at the Mandela National Stadium. The Uganda Cranes and their fans are the happiest set of people in this very region. Because why? Uganda have qualified for the next round. They have come through and picked maximum points from the opening two matches. 1-0 it was against South Sudan, and they have also come through with a 1-0 against Ethiopia in today's game. That means Ethiopia still has a mountain to climb if they are joined the defending champions in the next round. The first side to make it the next round, and trust me, most of the fans in the stadium here at the Mandela National Stadium will be very excited. And now I'm joined by the Ethiopian head tactician. The Uganda Cranes are through, but your team still has a mountain to climb.
As I said you before, at the opening game against South Sudan, this team is, you know, the hope team of the Ethiopian national team. This is the, you know, they are an experience in such kind of international match. So for today, even I'm not happy the way we are playing, but you know, the Ugandans were well organized in the whole field, the way how they are playing, the pattern of the game. So maximum, just to stop all the things, it is better. So as their other game, I can't say it's good, it's normal.
And now you have your final match that should be coming through against Kenya. It's going to be a hard one. How are you going to approach that one?
Of course, you know, we need to qualify from our group. The next match is with Kenya. So we have to do something to improve from better than this one, you know. So anyway, I'm happy what the players are doing in the field.
Thank you very much, coach, and I wish you all the best in your last game, and also hope Ethiopia can make it to the next round. All right, the coach suddenly is very enthusiastic. He thinks his side